What's going on, guys? It's your boy Scrub here, back again with another video. Hope you guys are having a great day. I know I am. And today I've got a story time for y'all. When back and I worked at the movie theater, and I ended up getting involved in this family's like family drama somehow. 0 out of 10, would not recommend. However, before we get into it, be sure to press the like button. Otherwise, no joke, no scam whatsoever. This is gonna happen to you, and trust me, it's very awkward to be in some family drama. Let's go. Nice racking her ass Brazilian, just turned 21, but my bank's a million. So, for those of you that don't know, one of the jobs I had before I was a YouTuber involved me working at a movie theater. And on this particular day, I was working later than usual. I think I had covered for somebody or had gotten called in because somebody had called out sick, something like that. So it wasn't my usual shift or my usual job at all. I normally was either like cleaning stuff up or in the projector room for something. So when I came in today, I was not only working later, but in a position that I never had done before, which was the ticket booth. And I worked at a movie theater that had started doing like online ordering, so usually being in the ticket booth was like the lamest, most boring job ever. Nothing really happened, you were just kind of standing there. Every now and then somebody would come get tickets. It was usually older people, people that didn't trust technology, that stuff, but for the most part, you're just kind of standing there. And I was off at like 11:30 or midnight, and it's probably about 10:30 p.m. when I watched this old man get out of his car and kind of start walking up to the ticket booth. And as I said, old people were the most common people that use the ticket booth, you know, so it wasn't surprising. He walks up to me and he seems normal enough, you know, I'm just kind of watching him walk up. And he gets up to the booth and I'm like, hey, how you doing, sir? And he's kind of grumpy when I ask him how he's doing. Like, he just kind of goes like, meh, you know, and I'm like, all right, okay. And I ask him again, like, all right, well, what can I get you today? Like, what do you want to see? Is there any tickets I can do for you? Do you already have a ticket? And this has been probably 2016, 2017. And he says, I want 2 tickets to Toy Story. And I'm really confused when he asked this because, you know, that wasn't necessarily a movie that we had available. In fact, I don't think that movie had been available for a very, very long time. Toy Story was my favorite movie when I was like a really little kid, and that's starting to become an alarmingly long time ago, so obviously it threw me off. And also, there was another thing weird about it. Which, you know, beyond just the fact that the movie isn't out anymore and hasn't been in theaters since, like, the 90s, is the fact that he had asked for 2 tickets to Toy Story, a movie that hadn't been out for, like, 20 years, almost 30. And on top of that, he's alone, so I don't know who the second ticket is for. If he's got an imaginary friend that's super insistent on seeing Toy Story, that's fine. I'm not here to judge anyone, but, you know, it definitely was a situation where I was a little bit confused. So when he asked for these 2 tickets to Toy Story, obviously I'm a little bit confused, and I don't think I took forever, but it felt like forever because it was just kind of awkward because I didn't really know what to say back to that. You know, usually people might ask for a time slot we didn't have or something, but I had never had anyone just like walk up to me and ask to see a movie in theaters that hadn't been in theaters for multiple decades, right? So I'm just kind of sitting there thinking about what to say, and I'm also thinking about the fact that he was a little grumpy, so I don't want to make him mad, and I'm like, well, sir, I don't think, you know, that's the correct movie because Toy Story isn't out right now and I can't really get tickets to a movie because we don't have a theater for it. And he seems confused when I say that. And he's like, what do you mean? And so I try to explain it again best I can, being like, well, you know, Toy Story is an older movie and we don't have a theater dedicated to it, so I can't give you tickets to that movie because it's not playing, right? You know, I try to explain it as best as I can. And instead of accepting it or like, you know, being like, oh, wrong theater, he looks at me and goes, that's not true. I want 2 tickets to Toy Story. And I really just don't know what to tell him. So I repeat it one more time, like, what, sir, Toy Story isn't out. I can't get you tickets. And he just doubles down and looks at me and is like, no, it is out. Get me 2 tickets to Toy Story. And he's starting to get kind of mad at me. And I don't know what to say to somebody that, like, isn't listening to me when I say we don't have that in theaters, dude. Like, what do you say when you say we don't have it? And they're like, yes, you do. You have to give it to me. I'm really confused, and I don't want to be fighting with this old man. Like, that's not in my cards of, like, what my house of cards on what I'm trying to do today. I'm not trying to be disrespectful. I'm not trying to be annoying. I'm not trying to be mean at all. So I'm just standing there silently, because at this point, I really have no clue what to say. And he's just staring at me. And when I say staring at me, like, it's not a nice ginger smile, you know? He's not, like, waiting for me to come up with a solution. He's just staring daggers at me. And he's like, well, great. Now, because of you not wanting to give me tickets to Toy Story, this is all your fault. And I'm like, what's all my fault? I don't know what he's referring to. I don't know what's my fault, what's not my fault. So, like I said, I ask him, what do you mean this is my fault? Because now something's my fault that I didn't do. And he's like, well, this is all your fault. Do you understand that, you know, I've been trying to find a theater that has Toy Story and you guys have it and now you're saying you don't have it and that's frustrating? And I'm like, I don't know what you Googled. We have not had Toy Story in a very, very long time. And he's like, well, this is all your fault. I got my grandson to come to the movies with me because he wanted to see Toy Story. And so now my grandson is going to be disappointed because of you. Like, this is all your fault. You're going to have to explain to him why he can't see his favorite movie. And, you know, he's going to be so sad. He might even go back into his depression because he's not able to see Toy Story. And I'm like, dude, I don't know what you want me to do. It's not my fault we don't have Toy Story. And if your grandson's going to, like, slip into a depression because you told him a movie theater had a movie that hasn't been out for 30 years, like, I don't know what to tell you. I don't say that out loud, obviously. I'm not gonna try to like make this guy more upset than he already is. So I'm just kind of standing there listening to this, and I genuinely am like, is he messing with me? Is he making this all up? Because I just don't see a situation where like you're bringing your grandson to the movie theater at 10:30 at night to watch Toy Story. Even if your grandson wanted to see it, it's like a school night. Why are you bringing him at 10:30 to watch Toy Story? But you know, I'm waiting for him to smile or laugh or like anything to indicate that it's a joke, and he's not laughing at all. If anything, he's looking more upset based on my silence, like the longer I'm just kind of standing there not knowing what to say. And he's just standing there silently now. So it's just this awkward silence. Both of us aren't talking whatsoever. And finally, I'm like, okay, well, I can't sell you tickets. And he's like, why not? And I'm like, because the movie doesn't exist. There's nowhere in this system on this computer for me to take your money and print tickets for Toy Story because we don't have it. I don't believe you. I'm telling you, online it said you had it. And I'm like, I don't know what website you're looking at. I'm looking at our website right now. I do not see Toy Story. I don't know what you're talking about. All right, guys, I'm going to interrupt the video for just 1 second. There's a gift card code on screen. I give one of these away in every video I post to say thanks to y'all for subscribing and turning on notifications. So if you wouldn't mind doing that, I'd appreciate it. And while you're at it, like and comment. It helps the video do better. If you already are subscribed with notifications on, then you're a legend, and I really, really do appreciate it. And on that note, I'll shut up. Thanks. And so we're kind of like, you know, just having this awkward situation, and I watch this dude get out of the car that the old guy drove up in and start walking up, and it's like this 30-year-old man. And based on the way he was talking about, you know, these Toy Story tickets, I was thinking like his grandkid had to have been young, you know, because he was acting like this person was just going to be so ridiculously not understanding of the situation, right? But up walks this 30-year-old man, not what I was expecting. And he seems like normal enough. He doesn't seem like he's gonna try to kill me because I don't have Toy Story in the theater. And he's talking to his grandpa and he's like, hey, is everything okay? You know, it's been a while, I'm coming up. You told me you were gonna come get me when you got the tickets. And his grandpa looks at him and is like, you're gonna be disappointed and upset and I'm sorry, you know, but don't take it out on me because it's not my fault. And the grandson's like, what's going on? Like, explain it to me. What is going on? And his grandpa won't tell him. He just continues to be like super dramatic. You can't blame me. I have nothing to do with this. It's out of my control. And his grandson is now like starting to get worried, obviously. If your grandparent keeps trying to hype it up like it's the worst thing to ever happen, you're gonna be concerned. And finally, he's like, grandpa, what happened? And that's when obviously now it becomes my fault. He's like, this idiot won't sell me tickets to Toy Story. I know that's one of your favorite movies. It's what I wanted to see. I thought they'd have it. But this guy's just refusing to sell me the tickets because he doesn't want to make money and he's an idiot. And I'm standing here like, all right, thanks, bro. Obviously, I'm an idiot. You're right. I come to work here at the movie theater for the sole purpose of standing here in this ticket booth and telling people that when they want to buy a ticket to a movie that it doesn't exist. That's why I'm here. That's why the company pays me, to tell people not to spend their money here. You got me, dude. You absolutely got me. You're right. Bamboozled. You own me. And so the grandpa's going off, and now the grandson is looking at me a little bit confused, right? And I start to explain, like, hey, so basically your grandpa walked up here and started saying that he wanted two tickets to Toy Story. We don't have Toy Story here. I'm sorry. I don't know what made him think we do. He says he saw it online. I can't find it on the website. I'm not calling him crazy. I'm just saying that we don't have it. And his grandpa's like, he's a liar. He's a liar. And at this point, I'm a little annoyed, right? And so I look at him and I go, it's not the 90s. Toy Story isn't in theaters. And he's like, see that attitude? Like, you could have just sold me the tickets. I know you have it here. We don't have it in theaters. And the grandson kind of looks at his grandpa and he goes, Grandpa, I don't want to see Toy Story anyways, and they don't have it. You know what I mean? Like, it's okay. I don't want to see Toy Story. We can see something else, and they don't have it. The movie hasn't been out forever. And, you know, on top of that, he goes, I'm 30. Toy Story was my favorite movie when I was like 6, right? So it's okay, but I don't need to see it. I'm not upset that they don't have it in theaters. And so now I'm even more confused because the grandpa was acting like this was going to make his grandson the most depressed person on the planet. He literally said, I might be responsible for bringing back his depression because Toy Story isn't in theaters. So the grandson kind of says this whole speech about how, like, I don't care. I'm not that mad about it. You don't have to do any of this. But now grandpa just starts yelling at both of us, dude. He's yelling at his grandson. And then when he's not yelling at his grandson, he gets back to yelling at me for lying about the movie not being here. And so he's just kind of switching back and forth, just yelling, you know, at everyone for everything. And I'm literally just standing here now because I don't know what to say or do. Like, it's not only my first night in the ticket booth, but they didn't really explain what to do in this situation when people start having arguments in front of you or like just demand to see a movie that doesn't exist. But whatever, I'm not replying anymore. I'm just keeping my mouth shut. And so I think his anger at me kind of goes away because he realizes that like I'm not gonna reply anymore. This has gotten way weirder than I ever wanted it to. I'm just not gonna reply. And so he starts going in on his grandson, and his grandson starts to argue back and be like, I don't want to see Toy Story. Why are you doing this? You always make everything a big deal and cause a scene. And then the grandpa is like, this is why I'm disappointed in you. You're such a disappointment. You act like a pansy. Just starts saying that he hates his grandson. He's so disappointed in him. All this horrible stuff, right? That nobody wants to hear from their grandpa. And the grandson's just kind of standing there because he doesn't know what to say. And finally, the grandson kind of lets him get it all out, and he goes, this is why we never call. You wonder why you never know what's going on in our life? It's because we try to go to the movies with you, and you end up screaming at the people in the ticket booth and calling me a disappointment. And at this point, I literally feel like I'm on like a trashy daytime reality TV show, bro. I had just come in to work a little bit, you know, get my bag up. I'm trying to be out here on my grind. Next thing I know, I'm in like the middle of this family feud, dude. I do not want to be here. Literally, I felt like I was on the Jerry Springer TV show, You Are Not the Father. But like, you know, when they're like, my dad sucks and I don't like him. And the dad's like, I didn't do anything wrong. So I feel like I'm on Dr. Phil at this point, right? I really, really do. I'm on Jerry Springer. It's just absolutely awful. And at this point, I'm uncomfortable because it's turned into like a family fight. They're saying that he's disappointed in his grandson. He's saying he never calls. Like, it's just not anything that I want to be a part of. So I start trying to make myself as small as possible. I'm not going to sit here and say that I hid behind the counter, all right? But like, I definitely kind of like backed up a little bit so I wouldn't be as prominently within eyesight and might have, you know, started organizing some files. I just didn't want to be involved anymore, bro. Tell me that you are like getting paid minimum wage and want to be involved in this family's drama when they're screaming at each other about why they never call and they're so disappointed in each other. I want nothing to do with it. But of course, like as I'm trying to make myself small, I think they kind of remembered I was there, and both of them are very upset. So they turn to me and they're like, well, who do you think is right in this situation? And honestly, I don't think that either one of you is very right in this situation. I think Grandpa is more wrong, and he shouldn't have called his grandson a disappointment, but it, from my perspective, you guys both suck for making me get involved in this, right? So I'm kind of standing there and they ask me what I think, and I'm just trying to not get involved. I don't want to insult either of them. I don't want to like, you know, make either of them more mad. So I just say the only thing I can think of in the moment, and I go, well, if you guys are going to spend time together, a movie might be a good idea because you guys can't argue during it, right? Which I know probably sounds really stupid. That's like the worst advice ever. Whatever, I'm 16. I don't know what's going on. These guys are screaming at each other. I just want them to leave. I don't want to be involved. And they both look at me and kind of like look annoyed with that response, which once again, what do you want me to say, bro? I'm out here to sell tickets. Of course, I'm going to try to get you to go see the movie. I would have hated to see the movie with them, though. Imagine being in that theater. They just start getting into a screaming match about Toy Story, like in the middle of the movie that they paid to see after they couldn't see Toy Story, you know? And this is why we should have seen Real Steel, Grandpa. So whatever, at that point, they just decide that they're not gonna see a movie. And that's fine with me, I don't care, as long as they are no longer my problem. So they're like, we're gonna leave, and they agree to leave. So they go to turn to leave, and they're walking away from me, and I'm like, finally, it's not my problem. But then Grandpa turns around and comes back and says, I bought two tickets, you gotta give me a refund. And I'm like, no you didn't, you guys never bought tickets, I'm not giving you a refund. And he's like, I bought tickets, give me a refund. And at this point, I'm like, dude, you guys didn't buy anything. We just had this whole argument. You guys were fighting forever about, you know, going to the movies and you decided you're not gonna go. And now you want a refund? So I'm like, give me your receipt. You didn't give me the receipt. You did that on purpose. And finally, after like 3 minutes, the grandson walks up and is like, Grandpa, we didn't buy the tickets. Let's go. Honestly, I think the grandson was waiting to see if I was gonna give it to him, because like, you know, if he would have gotten free money, I don't think he would have complained, but I just wasn't gonna like give the dude any money because they didn't buy the tickets. So whatever, they probably tried to just get a little free money out of the refund. I can't blame them, but they're finally walking away, and this time they don't turn around, they're not screaming at me, they just leave. And I'm feeling very relieved because obviously no one wants to be in that situation, bro. I finish my shift and I go home. And I'm just like, I don't know why this guy thought we had Toy Story on our theater. Because I went to the website when I got home and checked, and it wasn't there! So to this day, I have no clue why this guy thought that that was there. But anyways, guys, I think that's going to do it for the video. Hopefully you enjoyed. If you did, be sure to press the like button. Let me know in the comment section down below what you thought. And of course, subscribe if you're new and turn on notifications. If you really want to help me out, you can check out the intro song link down below, along with the link to my podcast, The Scuffedcast. Or you could use code SCRUBBY at the G Fuel checkout to get a discount on G Fuel and help me out. Last but certainly not least, I did go ahead and put some of my story times up on Spotify, so if you guys want to check those out, link will be in the top of the description. Feel free, helps me out, and you guys can listen to them offline. Thanks. But yeah, on that note, guys, that'll do it. Don't get anyone pregnant. If you do, make sure they're hot, and hopefully I'll see you guys next time. I'm out. Peace.